together with good friends. Everything is better with friends like you. There's so much to do in Peppermint Park. So won't you come along and we'll play. Happy to be sharing a fun day. Gonna keep you wearing a smiling face. It's a friendly place in Peppermint Park. We're gonna sing you a song.
Today on Peppermint Park. I thought maybe I'd come down here to the clubhouse before the rest of the gang to explain the difference between light and dark. Here, we'll use this light bulb. Right now it's on so we can see. It's nice and bright in here. It's sort of like when the bright sun's out or when you have a light on in your room. Now, when you turn the light out like this, oh, yeah. Now, it gets real dark. See there? You can't see anything. Everything is still here, but it's so dark, you can't even see it. That's the difference between light and dark. Uh-oh, I wonder who that is. I heard somebody come in, but I can't see them because it's so dark in here. I guess I'd better turn on the light and find out who it is. Oh, it's Nurkle. Hi, Nurk. I was just explaining the difference between light and dark. See, when the light's on, you can see things, and when it's off like this, it's dark, and you can't look at anything.
Yeah, and you know what else, Norky?
What?
When it's dark, you can't see where you're going, either.
Ugh. Hey, maybe I should have given him a flashlight.
Today on Peppermint Park, we're learning about the letter G. The letter G. It's the first letter in the word green. It's also the first letter in the word gorilla. The letter G, it's the first letter in the word giraffe.
Did you ever wanna be tall like me? Did you ever wanna be a giraffe? Eat your dinner from the tallest tree. When you're on your knees, anytime you please, giraffe. You can see it all when you're 10 feet tall. You'd be cool in school, don't laugh. You could beat 'em all playing basketball like Kareem Abdul, giraffe. Did you ever want a 6-foot throat, a fuzzy coat? Did you ever wanna be a giraffe and be covered with these funny spots? Tie your neck in knots, think the strangest thoughts. Giraffe, watch the clouds go by, down around your thigh. Have a high-rise neck, oh, but what the heck? I am the tallest of all of the animals, 91 inch and a half. Giraffe.
Yeah! it's me, Ernie. Today on Peppermint Park, we're introducing the letter...
Wait a minute. Just a minute here. Oh, hi, Ernie. Sorry to interrupt. It's me, Snarky. Today, we're talking about the letter T. And guess what? The famous singing group, the Manhattan T's, have just been spotted over on T Street. And they're about to sing their famous song about the letter T. Just wait till you see this.
That's the letter for me.
You can't see.
There's no other letter will ever be better than T. 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 That's the letter for me.
The letter T.
Don't ever forget her. There's no better letter than T.
Here at the Peppermint Park fire station. Gee, I hope he shows up.
Hi, Piggle.
Oh, hi, Sparky.
How you doing?
Fine.
All right. You know, today we have another fire prevention message. Are you ready for it?
Yeah, what is it?
All right, let me ask you. Do you know what to do if your clothes catch on fire?
Well, nah.
Well, have you ever heard this before? Stop, drop, and roll.
Oh, yeah, that's a song. Stop, drop, and roll.
No, come on. Peggle, that's Shake, Rattle, and Roll, the song. That's not Stop, Drop, and Roll. Stop, Drop, and Roll is what we do if our clothes catch fire.
Oh.
All right, now you listen to this. If your clothes should catch on fire, which we don't ever want, we don't play with matches, we never run because the fire will get bigger and burn us real bad.
Oh.
We never run. We stop, we drop to the ground, we cover our face with our hands, and we roll over and over and over and put that fire out. Can you remember all that?
Yeah, that sounds great.
All right, let me give you the test. If your clothes catch fire, do we ever run?
No.
No, we never run. What do?
We stop, then we drop. Then we roll.
That's right. Stop, drop, and remember, cover your face with your hands and roll the fire out. That's our message for today. And you know, at the end of our message, we have to take the Sparky Pledge because that says we tell somebody else. Are you ready?
Yeah.
All right. Place your hand over your heart. Look at Johnny out there. He's got... Johnny, your hand over your heart. Okay, we ready? Okay, repeat after me. I promise Sparky...
I promise, Sparky.
When I go home today.
When I go home today.
I will tell two people.
I will tell two people.
What Sparky had to say.
What Sparky had to say.
Okay, you remember all those messages and you'll get along just fine. I have to go now, Piggle, so you have a good day with the boys and girls and we'll talk to you again next time, all right?
Okay.
Okay, Piggle, bye-bye.
Bye. Gee, I think I like it better. As a song, stop, drop, and roll.
Today's official letter on Peppermint Park is the letter T. One of these letters is the small letter T. Is it this one? Or perhaps it's this one. Remember, we're looking for the small letter T. Is it this one? Or maybe this is the small letter T. Which one could it be? Which letter? That's right. It's right here. This is the small letter T. And all the rest are capital letters.
The letter T.
All dressed up and nowhere to go. I'm just a bird in a tuxedo. Can't go out, can't stay in. What am I gonna do? The other birds all laugh at me just because I can't fly. They don't know that I can go to places that they would never try. We could swim around all day. We like it nice and icy, see. We don't catch colds. And when we say Antarctica's paradise for a penguin, we really mean it. Cause penguins don't fly south for the winter. What are we gonna do?
Penguins
sure could use a new igloo.
Penguins,
my toes are turning blue.
Penguins,
doodly doodly doo.
Now, boys and girls, here's the Peppermint Park Story Lady.
Hi, boys and girls. Today on Peppermint Park, we have a very special story about finding a new friend. It's called The Lost Puppy. One day, Alan and his sister Alice were playing a game of hide-and-seek. Alan was hiding behind a big green bush when he heard a little barking sound. He looked under the branches of the bush and found a little brown puppy. Oh, my, said Alan. Aren't you the prettiest little puppy I've ever seen? Alan called to his sister Alice. Oh, my, said Alice. Where did you find such a pretty puppy? Alan pointed under the bush. He must be lost, said Alice. What are we going to do? Asked Alan. The two children sat down and tried to think of what to do. Can we keep him? Asked Alan. If he's lost, then he must have a home, said Alice. Someone might be looking for him. Alan and Alice took the puppy to their mother, who said, that sure is a pretty puppy, but we should take him to the animal shelter. That way, whoever is looking for him will find him. At the shelter, they showed the puppy to the officer, Miss White. What a pretty little puppy, she said. I'm sure someone will be looking for him. Thank you for bringing the puppy here. When we get older, maybe we'll have a puppy someday, said Alice. I'm sure you'll take very good care of your puppy when you do, said Miss White. When they were ready to leave, a little girl came running in. Oh, you found my puppy, she said happily. You found my puppy. Miss White handed her the little puppy and told her that Alan and Alice had brought the puppy in. The little girl smiled and said, thank you for finding my little puppy and for bringing him to the shelter. We looked all over for him. Oh, we found him playing hide and seek, said Alan. He sure is a pretty puppy, said Alice. Thank you for finding him, said the little girl. And if you ever want to play with him, you can come to my house. Thank you, said Alan and Alice. We will. And that, boys and girls, is how Alan and Alice found a lost puppy and a new friend. Join us next time on Peppermint Park for another fun story.
Looks like this man's going to make something out of metal. Yeah, see how he's bending it? It's really spinning fast. I wonder what it's going to be. I don't know. Let's watch. He's rounding off the end. looks sort of like a tube. Yeah. What do you think it's going to be?
I don't know.
Now they're putting it together. I know, it's some kind of horn. I know what it is. It's a trumpet. Yeah, a trumpet.
Trumpet.
Hello there. As you all know, I am the famous inventor, Professor Goodstuff. And I'm here to show you how to make something wonderful to play with. And it's edible. That means you can also eat it. Oh, my, yes. It's one of my latest inventions, you know. But first, you'd better get your mother or father in the room, or maybe a babysitter, or at least an adult you know, because this stuff might be a little hard for you to do. Goodness knows it certainly is hard enough for me. Oh, I will remember one time when... Oh, that's another story. Is Mommy there yet? Let me look there. Oh, there you are. Okay, are you ready now? You see, we are going to make a clay for you to make some toys with. And then, if you don't like the toys, then you just eat them. Oh, I'm sorry. You see, sometimes my inventions really get me excited. Well, anyway, here's the recipe. This is what you need. You see, it's right there. 2 cups of powdered dry milk. 2 cups of smooth peanut butter. I guess you could use the chunky kind, but then the clay would be all lumpy and you wouldn't want that now, would you? Oh, my, no. Well, anyway, you also add 1 cup of honey. The bees will give you that, you see. And you mix all the ingredients together, and the result will be tremendous, thanks to me, Professor Goodstuff. Now, remember, boys and girls, you don't do this unless a grown-up is with you to help you. Okay? I'll be back on another show to tell you about one of my greatest inventions. It's all about this... it's about this great big... That was last week. I know what it was.
Let's count to the number 7.
If I had my way every day, I would make the whole world green. Not the sky above or the friends you love, but I can't get enough of green. Take vegetables, for instance, the things you never like to finish. Now I ask you, have you ever seen a prettier shade of green than the green you've seen in broccoli, lettuce, okra, cabbage, peas, green beans, and parsley, endive, cucumbers, and spinach? If I had my way, I would say, make the whole world green like spring. Every zebra stripe, every fruit that's ripe. Now wait a minute. If every fruit was green, why on this green earth would you call an orange? Every living, breathing thing, if they all were green, like a small insect, then the great green frog could get more respect. If the
was green, then I wreck all that. There would be no grass stains on the knees of all your jeans if the world was green.
Oh, big, very big, big, big.
Hi, I'm just little, very little.
This picture is big. Now it's little. Uh-oh, big again. It's getting smaller. Now the picture's little. It's getting larger. Now it's big. Little.
Once again, boys and girls, it's time for Magic Megan.
Hi, boys and girls. How would you like to be able to say to your friend, with a few magic words and a few magic tricks, I can walk through this piece of paper? Well, I'm going to show you how you can say that to your friend. First of all, you fold the paper in half. Maybe you should say the magic words, Nagim Kijam, first. That's Magic Megan backwards. Then, you cut towards the fold of the paper on each side, about a fourth of an inch in. Okay? Then you turn the paper over and cut about a fourth of an inch, not quite all the way, leave about this much on each side. Just keep doing that, alternating each side. Okay? And this is what your paper should look like right here. Like an accordion. Now open up your piece of paper. Then cut down the middle, but don't cut the first one or the last one. Cut down the middle. Okay? And then look! You can walk through this piece of paper just like you told your friends you could. Well, that's my trick for today, boys and girls. Bye for now.
You gotta learn how to do if you wanna grow up and be a big kid too. It's not skipping or jumping or singing boogaloo. You gotta learn how to tie your shoe. There's one thing that I'm trying to say. I think that I can do it if I try every day. It's the one thing that I really wanna do. I gotta learn how to tie my shoe. Maybe someone could teach me those ropes. I'll ask a friend and maybe then I'll hope that one day when you least expect it, I'll have tied my shoes perfected. There's one thing that I know I can do. Now I know how to tie my shoes. So if you practice and don't feel blue, you can learn how like the beauty.
Join us next time on Peppermint Park when we'll see how drums are made. We'll learn all about the letter P. And you and your friends can take a magical trip to the park. And of course, much more. See you soon.
Good friends, gonna get together with good friends. Everything is better with friends like you. There's so much to do in Peppermint Park. So won't you come along and we'll play. Happy to be sharing a fun day.
gonna keep you wearing a smiling face. It's a friendly place in Peppermint Park. We're gonna sing you a song.